Good morning, everyone. Good morning, students. How are you? So, on behalf of Pearson Academy, I have the pleasure to welcome you to the second face-to-face class. My name is Eliana Cifuentes, and I am tutor of Pearson Academy. Well, here I have the calendar. According to the calendar, today we have our second face-to-face class. It is December 14th, okay? And I always recommend to check your academic calendars. Please, here we have, for example, our next important date. It is on December 19th. Si usted quiere cambiar de centro para dar su examen de primera oportunidad, puede hacerlo el del 19 de diciembre al 7 de enero. Nuestro examen de primera oportunidad, our first final test, will be on January 17th. De acuerdo a nuestro calendario, el examen final será en enero 17 al 19 y las notas serán publicadas en febrero 3. Okay? So please check your academic calendar. Well, I always remind you the methodology. I always advise to work on the platform. Remember, if you work on the platform, you will have 10 extra points. Tendrán 10 puntos extras si trabajan en plataforma. Recuerden, todavía estamos a tiempo de poder realizar todas las actividades en plataforma. Si no lo pudieron hacer como asignación, que es la metodología que estamos utilizando, si no pudieron hacerlo como asignación, lo pueden hacer como práctica. Ingresan a través de la pestaña de curso para hacer sus prácticas. Pueden todavía igualarse todas las actividades anteriores, aquellas que no pudieron realizar, la pueden hacer ingresando por la pestaña de curso. Let me show you. ¿Ok? Aquí. And assignments. Here, you will have all the assignments. Si no pudieron hacer sus asignaciones, usted puede ingresar a la pestaña de curso y realizar como prácticas. Recuerden, las prácticas no tienen la misma evaluación de las asignaciones, pero le va a ayudar para practicar su idioma inglés. Ok. Su examen final es sobre, su examen final, como usted sabe, es sobre 40 puntos. Para recibir sus puntos extras en la plataforma, de plataforma, en su examen final debe tener por lo menos 20 puntos, 20 sobre 40 para que reciba los puntos extras de plataforma. Y usted necesita 28 puntos para aprobar su nivel. Si está trabajando activamente en la plataforma, usted tiene 3 oportunidades para pasar su nivel. Un primer final test y 2 make-ups, o sea, 2 exámenes supletorios. Si no trabajó en la plataforma, tendrá una sola oportunidad, su final test. Y esperamos que apruebe con 28 puntos para aprobar su nivel. Todo lo que usted realiza en la plataforma, recuerde, es válido por 10 puntos. 2 puntos equivalen a todas las actividades de reading, 2 points for writing, 2 points for listening, and 4 points for speaking. ¿Ok? Well, this is a face-to-face class. This is a normal class, So my dear students, try to participate in class, okay? And we are going to have a check of verb questions with who, how, and how old, the adverbs very and so, prepositions of place and time, in and at, the ordinal numbers, months of the year, the use of this, that, these, and those, a review of the simple present tense, and some examples. Remember, this is your class, so try to participate. Raise your hand and take the microphone and participate. Okay? So, please, could you tell me your names? I see some students in Santo Domingo. In Santo Domingo, please, could you introduce yourselves? Chicos de Santo Domingo, por favor, pueden presentarse, pueden decirme sus nombres. Hola. ¿En algún otro sitio, por favor? Okay, great. Hello?
Anda, my name is Viviana Valverde.
Liliana?
Viviana Valverde.
Viviana, thank you, Viviana. Welcome to this class. Where are you from? Where are you now? ¿De dónde estás? ¿Dónde estás tú?
Guaranda.
Ah, Guaranda. Thank you. ¿Tienes otros compañeros allí?
No, solamente estoy yo por el momento.
Okay, only you. Right, thank you very much, Viviana. Students in Santo Domingo, please. Viviana, ¿sería por favor posible que te quedes con el micrófono? Porque vamos a tener una clase participativa, ¿ok? Una clase activa.
Sí,
sería bueno
tengo.
Que te quedes con el micrófono. Ok. Santo Domingo. ¿En alguna otra provincia, por favor, chicos?
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning. How are you?
Yo soy Zambrano de Tulcán.
Tulcán, what's your name?
Geoffrey Zambrano, teacher.
Geoffrey. Thank you,
yes.
Geoffrey.
Good morning,
do you have
teacher.
More classmates? Good morning.
My name is Lady Chimbo, Zamora.
Lady from Zamora. Thank you very much. In Zamora, are there more students? ¿Hay más estudiantes en Zamora?
Solo estoy yo.
Okay, en Tulcán, Geoffrey, ¿hay más estudiantes en Tulcán?
No, solo estoy yo presente.
Only you. Okay, thank you. Zamora, Tulcán, Guaranda. More students, please.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
Guillermo Medrano del Puyo.
Guillermo, thank you very much. Guillermo from El Puyo. Thank you. No more students in your class?
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
My name is Joana Burgos.
Joana Burgos, thank you. Where are you, Joana?
Ibarra. I live in Ibarra.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Are teacher. There more students in the okay, good morning.
Good morning, teacher.
Yeah?
Good morning.
Good morning. What's your name?
My name is Rosa.
Rosa. Where are you, Rosa? ¿En dónde estás? Santo Domingo. Excellent. And yeah.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
My name is Ligia.
Ligia.
Sí, de Morona, Santiago, Macas.
Macas. Thank you very much. Welcome, Ligia. In Morona, in Macas, are there more students?
No, estoy sola.
Only you. Only you. Okay, thank you. So, more students, please.
Good morning, teacher.
Hello.
Hola.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello.
My name is Ariana Rodriguez.
Ariana Rodriguez.
Sí.
Where are you? Where are you?
I live in Machala.
Machala, thank you very much. Welcome, Machala. Ariana. Ariana, are there more students in your class?
No, estoy solita. No hay más.
Okay, no problem. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Well, what about, let me see, Ambato. I have a student in Ambato. I suppose to have students from El Coca, no Coca, Esmeraldas, Oranda, Latacunga, Macas, Machala, Nueva Loja, Puerto Viejo, Puyo, Riobamba. What about Riobamba? Quevedo, no, Tena, Tulcán, Zamora, Ambato, Quito, San Rafael. Do I have students in Quito? No? Okay. Okay, dear students, welcome back to this face-to-face class. Well, I am very happy because we are going to have a very active class. So your participation is very important, please. So take your microphones and participate. So here we have the contents. This is the material. This is the material you have studied, okay, on the first level from units. I suppose you are in unit number 7, maybe, from units 5, 6, 7, and so on, okay? So, if you have a specific question, si tienen alguna pregunta específica, por favor, you can ask. Well, let's check some vocabulary. Okay, let me see, what is it? Yeah. Aha, parents. Here I have a vocabulary about family relationships. All right, parents, son, husband, wife. Tell me more family relationships. Tell me more. Can you remember? A ver, chicos, vamos. Dígame más nombres family relationships. What can you say? Husband, son, wife. What else?
Grandchildren.
Hey, grandchildren, excellent. What else? Yeah, give me more.
Uncle.
Uncle, great. Yeah, remember more.
Daughter.
What?
Daughter, hija.
Ah, daughter, excellent. Daughter. Repeat, daughter.
Daughter.
Daughter, excellent. What else? Yeah, more. More vocabulary. Daughter. Yeah, I have daughter. What else? No more?
Sister.
Sister. Yeah. Grandson. What else? Brother. More.
Brother.
What? Brother. Grandchildren. Yeah, more.
Grandparents.
Grandparents, excellent. Grandparents, good. What else?
Cousin.
Cousin. Hey, yeah, great. Cousin. And more? No more? Brother, sister, father, mother, husband, wife, daughter. Okay, here we have a family relationship. Right. So there are more words. So here, in unit number 5, I think, you have questions with who. And I say, hey, who is he? Who is he? I'm showing this person. Who is he?
Grandparents.
You can say the name.
Ben.
And I am asking in singular, who is he? Who is he?
Husband.
You can say he is Ben. Who is he? Try to form a sentence. We say he is Ben. Who is he?
He is Ben.
Yeah, and who is she?
She is Ida.
She is Ida. And who is she?
Ida is mother de Tania.
Uh-huh. But first of all, we are going to say only names. Vamos solo nombres, yeah? Who is he? He is Ben. Who is she? She is Ida. Who is she? She is Tania. Who is he?
He is Edwin.
He's Edwin. Who is she?
He's Samantha.
She is Samantha. And who is he?
He is Jacob.
Jacob. Okay, he's Jacob. Excellent. So, if we have a question, who is he? We use the subject he, the verb is, and we say Ben. Who is he? He is Ben. Right. Who is he? He is Ben. Who is she? She is Tania. Look at the order of the question. We use who to ask for people. All right. Who are they? They are Samantha and Jacob. Who are they? Okay, who are they? Who are they?
They are a family.
All right, we can say they are family. We can say they are Tania and Edwin. Who are they? Only these two people. Who are they? They are Ida and Ben. Who are they? Only these two. Who are they?
Samantha and Jacob.
Yeah, but try to say a full sentence. You can say, they are Samantha and Jacob. And who are they?
They are Tania and Edwin.
They are Tania and Edwin. And who are they?
They are Ida and Ben.
They are Ida and Ben. Okay, now you can use contraction and we can say there, Ida and Ben, there, Tania and Edwin, and there, Samantha and Jacob. Excellent. Now, according to the family tree, what do you think? Who is Samantha? Samantha is, according to Tania, what is the relationship between Tania and Samantha? ¿Qué es Samantha con relación a Tania?
Daughter.
Yeah, it is her daughter. Podríamos decir lo mismo Samantha es la hija de Tania, ¿verdad? Samantha is Tania's daughter. ¿Sí? Samantha is Tania's daughter. All right, sorry. Yeah, we say, who is Ben? According to the family tree, we say, who is Ben? This is Ben. Who is Ben? Ben, according to Ida, or the relation with Ida, we say, Ben is Ida's husband. Ben is Ida's husband. Decimos aquí, Ben es el esposo. The apostrophe and the letter S means possession. This means possession. We use an apostrophe and the letter S to express possession. ¿Quién posee a quién? Okay. ¿Quién posee a Ben? Ida. Entonces, a Ida le ponemos el apostrophe y decimos, Ben is Ida's husband. Now, who is Ida? Who is Ida?
Ida is Ben's husband.
Husband. Repeat. Husband. Excellent. Ida is Ben's husband. O sea, es la esposa. And I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Ida is Ben's wife, no husband. It's Ben's wife. Let's ask. Who is Tania? Who is Tania?
Tania is Edwin's wife.
Tania is Edwin's wife. Excellent. Tania and wife, they are the same person. They are the same person. Ben and husband, they are the same person. So we say Ida is Ben's wife. Ida and wife is the same person. Who is Samantha? According to Jacob. Who is Samantha?
Samantha is Jacob's sister.
Ya, pero tienes que pronunciar el apóstrofe y la letra S. Samantha is Jacob's sister. Don't forget to pronounce apostrophe and letter S. Este apóstrofe y la letra S en español significan de. Dice, Samantha es la hermana de ¿quién? De Jacob. Hermana de Jacob. All right, excellent. Now, who is Ben related to Jacob? Who is Ben in relation with Jacob? ¿Qué es Ben relacionado a Jacob? ¿Qué es Ben para Jacob?
Ben is grandfather of Jacob.
Ajá. Para no decir of Jacob's, decimos el apóstrofe. Ben is Jacob's grandfather. Ben is Jacob's grandfather. O sea, Ben es el abuelo de Jacob. ¿Quién posee al abuelo? Jacob. Por tanto, a Jacob le ponemos el apóstrofe y la S. Now, what is Jacob what is Ida for Jacob? Ida para Jacob, ¿qué es?
Ida. Hola.
Yes. Yes.
Ida is Jacob's grandmother. Grandmother.
Jacob's.
Jacob.
Jacob's grandmother. Excellent. Ida is Jacob's grandmother. What is Edwin? What is Edwin for Jacob?
Is Jacob's father.
Edwin is, repeat, Edwin.
Edwin is Jacob's father.
But pronounce apostrophe and S. Jacob's. Clearly. Jacob's.
Jacob's.
Jacob's father.
Father.
Or Jacob's dad. What is Tanya for Jacob?
Tanya is Jacob's mother.
Excellent. Tanya is Jacob's mom or Jacob's mother. Very good. What is Samantha? Okay, what is Samantha for Ben?
Ben is Samantha's...
No, Samantha.
Samantha. Samantha. Grandfather.
Samantha is...
Samantha...
Is...
Samantha is granddaughter of Ben's.
Samantha is Ben's... What?
Granddaughter.
Wife? No. This is Samantha.
Samantha is Ben's grandchildren.
Okay, children is in plural. You can say Samantha and Jacob. Samantha and Jacob are Ben's grandchildren. Because it is in plural. Children, grandchildren. Only Samantha, you can say grandchild. Okay? Only Jacob, grandson. El nieto de Ben, right? What about Tanya for Ben? What is Tanya for Ben? Or for Ben and Ida? What is Tanya for Ida and Ben? Tanya?
Tanya is Ben's sister.
Tanya is Ben's sister? No.
Tanya is Tanya is Ben's daughter.
Tanya is Ben's daughter. Excellent. Tanya is Ben's daughter. Tanya is Ben's is Ida's daughter. And for them in plural, Tanya is Ida and Ben's daughter, right? Okay, this is the possessive noun. Remember, we add apostrophe and letter S to express possession. If I say, este celular, this is my cell phone. Using a possessive noun, what can you say? You can say, this is teacher's cell phone. I add apostrophe S to the person who possesses the object. In this case, the cell phone. I say, who possesses the object? ¿Quién tiene el objeto? The teacher. And I say, the teacher's cell phone. The teacher's cell phone. Right? Do you understand?
Teacher, one question. En el caso de querer decir que Samantha es hija de Edwin y Tania, ¿cómo sería la escritura por el apóstrofe?
Samantha is Tania and Edwin's daughter. El apóstrofe y la letra S se pone al último, a la última persona. En este caso, Tania and Edwin's apostrophe. In plural, right? Because here we have two people, Tania and Edwin A Edwin, a la última persona, le pongo el apóstrofe and letter S. Right? Now, look at this. If I have a word, let's see. If I have a word, for example, Carlos, y quiero decir que Carlos tiene una casa. La casa de Carlos. ¿Cómo diría la casa de Carlos? ¿Quién posee el objeto?
De Carlos Home.
Carlos posee el objeto. Por tanto, a Carlos, le pongo el apóstrofe y la letra S. But in this case, let me see. Where is the apostrophe here? Sorry, I don't have here the apostrophe. I don't know where is the apostrophe here. Well, I don't know where is the apostrophe. Chicos, no sé dónde está el apóstrofe in this computer. All right, anyway. No. I'm sorry, I don't have the apostrophe here. But if I have a word, a noun, we call possessive noun because this word is a noun. If the word ends in the letter S, it is not necessary to add another S. We only add the apostrophe. We only add the apostrophe. We're supposed to say Carlos. We're supposed to say Carlos apostrophe S. Esa sería la regla, ¿verdad? Carlos house. Let me see. This could be Carlos house, but as the word, as the noun ends in the letter S, it is not necessary to add the letter S. We only say Carlos house. You see? Cuando la palabra, cuando el sustantivo ya termina en una letra S, no necesito añadir el apóstrofe y la S. Solamente el apóstrofe es suficiente. And we say Carlos house. And how do you say el celular de Juan? ¿Cómo sería el celular de Juan? Repeat again.
Juan's cell.
Excellent. We say Juan's apostrophe S. I use this one and I say Juan's cell. Juan's cell phone. This is Juan's cell phone. This is Eliana's cell phone. This is Eliana's mouse. This is Eliana's pen. Right? ¿Cómo digo? El nombre de mi mamá. ¿Quién posee el nombre? Mi mamá. Entonces, a mi mamá le pongo apostrophe and S. How do you say this? Para no decir the name of my mom, si ve que es muy largo, it's too long, the name of my mom, we don't use this phrase. We only say my mom's name, and that's it. Aquí dice el nombre de mi mamá. Como digo, el carro de mi tío. We are talking about possession. El carro de mi tío.
Car's uncle.
¿Quién posee el carro? Recuerden, le pongo el apóstrofe y la letra S a la persona o al objeto que posee el carro. ¿Quién posee el carro? Mi tío.
My uncle.
¿No es cierto? Entonces va primero my uncle. Y digo, my uncle's a la persona que posee. My uncle's car. My uncle's car is red. ¿Cómo digo? El escritorio de Teresa. No, el escritorio de mi tía. Right?
My uncle's desk.
Yeah, you say my aunt's desk. And then we say my dad's. Give me an example. My dad's what? My dad's book. Right? Yeah, give me more examples using apostrophes. Give me more examples using apostrophes. Give me more examples. No?
Teacher, necesariamente tiene que ser my, no de cómo sé con el carro, el escritorio de...
No. You can say Maria's book. This is Maria's book. Right? El libro de María. Para no decir, the book of Maria. You see, this is too long. The book of Maria. No, we don't say like this. We only say Maria's book. Right? Do you understand? Yes or no?
John's pencil.
What?
John's pencil.
Excellent. I said, this is John's pencil. We don't say pencil, we say pencil. John's pencil. What else? Give me more examples. Cualquier objeto y cualquier persona. Vamos. Nouns. No, no idea.
Samantha's computers.
Samantha's, excellent. This is a good question. This is a good example. Samantha's computers. This is in plural. Samantha's computers. Samantha's computers are old. Excellent. Samantha's computers are old. Yeah. One more example.
Kathy's dog.
Kathy's dog. This is Kathy's dog. Oh, Kathy's dog is cute. Kathy's dog is cute. Y no decimos, the dog of Kathy is cute. No? Kathy is cute. Well, excellent, my dear students. So let's continue. Right? Now, we are going to introduce yourself. I say, for example, hello, I am Eliana. And you don't have friends in your class. Imagine that you introduce. Cuando digo voy a presentar a un amigo, no digo present, digo introduce. And we say, hello, I am Eliana, and this is my friend Carlos. I suppose I have here a friend Carlos. In your classroom, do you have a classmate? No? ¿En sus clases no hay otro compañero? No?
No.
Unfortunately, we don't have friends. All right. Well, this example was to talk in pairs, to talk, but if you don't have classmates now, no problem. We say, hello, I am Eliana, and this is my friend Carlos. He is an engineer, or she is an engineer, what else? Well, we are going to practice using some adjectives. For example, good looking, handsome, tall, pretty, cute, young, and short. So try to introduce your mom, your family. Imagine that your family is near you. Okay, what can you say? And this is my sister, for example. Yeah. Try to introduce your sister and describe your sister. What can you say? Oh, for example, Viviana.
Hello, I am Joanna, and this is my sister, Diana. She is very pretty.
She's very pretty. Pretty.
Pretty.
Excellent. She is tall or short? Is she tall or short?
She is tall.
Uh-huh. So then you can say, she is tall and very pretty. Excellent. Well, another one. Geoffrey.
Hello, I am Byron, and this is my sister, Kathy. He is tall.
He or she? He or she?
But,
she
is pretty. He is very tall.
She's very tall. She is very pretty. She's young. She's cute. Excellent, very good. One more student. What about Guillermo from El Puyo?
Hello, I am Guillermo, and this is my friend Paul. He's chemical engineer.
He's what?
Chemical engineer.
Yeah, she's an engineer, right? And try to describe his physical appearance.
She's short.
She's short, right? She's short. Is he handsome? Is she good looking? Is he young? Hey, is he young or old? You can say he is young, you can say he is short, he is handsome, etc. All right, so when we want to emphasize the adjective, we can use these words, very and so. Very and so. Very and so, they have the same meaning, okay? They are used to make adjectives stronger. And we say, very is used in a formal way. Very is formal. And so it is informal. But they have the same meaning, right? Say, Samantha is very beautiful. But we can say, Samantha is so beautiful. It is the same, right? Samantha is so young. Remember, very and so, they have the same meaning. Very is formal and so is informal, right? Now, here I have a couple. Try to describe these people using very and so. What can you say about this picture? Using very and so. Try to use. Invent, imagine their names, create their names. What can you say about this? Try to describe these people. Imagine that he is Carlos and she is Kathy, right? So we can say, Kathy and Carlos are very happy. Carlos and Kathy are very happy. Yeah. Or you can say, Carlos and Kathy are so happy. So, what else? Tell me more. No, no idea. Very and so, they are before an adjective. They go before an adjective. Vamos, deme un adjetivo cualquiera. No? No idea? Hello, are you still there?
They are very smart.
They are very smart. Yeah, excellent. You can say they're very smart. And so, using so? If you say so, try to use so. You can say they are very smart. Kathy is very happy. Kathy is very intelligent. Louis is very tall. What else? They are so interesting. What about the car? What about the car?
Carla is Carla very so good looking?
Okay, repeat again, please. Carla.
Carla very so good looking.
All right. Pay attention to this. We suppose this is Carla, right? I don't know what happened with this. Yeah. First of all, my dear, we need the verb be. ¿Dónde está el verbo to be? Siempre tengo que tener la estructura de una oración. Samantha is. Samantha is very, pero si uso very, ya no utilizo so al mismo tiempo. O very or so. Y digo, Carla is very, normally good looking is used for men. We can say, para hombres es usado más, ¿no? We can say she's so pretty. So pretty. Pretty. Yeah, but pay attention. If you use very, you don't say so. Only one, or very or so. You say, Carla is so pretty. Carla is very pretty, right? Now, give me examples about you. Vamos, I am. Using so and very, you say, I am so pretty. I am so pretty. I am very intelligent. So give me more examples about you using very and so. Hello.
The car is very old.
The car is very old. Excellent. The car is so old. Very good. Very formal way. So informal. I say the car is so old. Yeah, very good. Yeah, more examples. Use I. Vamos, try to describe yourself. I am so pretty, I am so intelligent, I am so happy, I am so... Give me more adjectives. I am so thirsty. I am so hungry. Say, oh, I am so hungry. It's very early and I am so hungry. Give me more examples using I.
I am very little.
I am very early, yeah? Use more adjectives. Tell me more adjectives. No, no idea. You can say, I am so tired. I'm so tired. I'm very tired. Give me more examples. Come on. Using very or so. Hello.
Teacher, y I am, no podemos abreviar ahí con el apóstrofe.
Yes, remember we use apostrophe for informal writing. We say, I am, El problema es que no tengo el apóstrofe en esta computadora, no lo encuentro. But you can use apostrophe and we say, I'm so tired. Very good. I don't know where is the apostrophe. Well, let's suppose this is the apostrophe. Yeah, I'm so tired. Imagine this is the apostrophe. It is not, but yeah. Give me more examples. Come on.
I am so funny.
Yeah, good. Well, more examples.
I am very friendly.
I'm very friendly. Excellent. I'm very friendly or I am so friendly. Right. Okay. So no questions, no more questions. This is not difficult, right? Good. Let's continue with other topic. Here we have the words very and so. Now tell me about your family. What about your wife? Try to describe your wife, your son, your girlfriend, your brother, your grandparents, your cousin, your sister. How about your uncle? How about your... And here we have some adjectives. You can say fun or funny, smart, short, intelligent, good looking, tired, hungry. Sorry, this is not hangy, this is hungry. Hungry, and this is thirsty, right? So, yeah. Yeah, tell me about your family, but very quickly, please. We have to form a sentence. You can say, my wife, Maria, is very short. For example, my grandparents are so tired. Yeah, give me more examples. You have here an example. My husband is very intelligent. Yeah, what about you?
My brother is very intelligent.
Good, excellent. Now, using so.
My sister is very smart.
It's very smart. Remember, very is the formal way. You can use so. This is an informal communication, so we can say so. Yeah, use so.
My sister is very short.
Yeah, or so. So short, yeah. What else? No more?
My uncle is so angry.
My uncle is so hungry. Very good. Right, excellent. So this is the review of very and so. Remember, very and so, they all these words go before an adjective. Van delante de un adjetivo, right? Now, to express possession, we can also use the verb have and has. We use have with I, you, we, and they, and we use has with he, she, and it. Do you remember? Now, tell me about your family. You can say, I have one brother and one sister. My brother's name is Luis, and my sister's name is Maria. Maria has, and then you can continue. Maria has, etc. Yeah. Now, tell me about your family. I want to meet your family. I want to know about your family. Vamos, Rosa, Ligia, Ariana. Tell me something about your family. Are you still there? For example, yeah. Tell me something about your family. Using have for I, you, we, they, and has for he, she, or it. Yeah.
I have 4 brothers and 4 sisters. My brother's name is Abel, Aldrin, Robin, Milton. And my sister's name is Lida, Lady, Odalia, y María.
Okay, you're described in plural. So you can say, my brother's name, in plural, are. We don't say is. Is for singular, are is for plural. You say, my brothers, in plural, names. My brothers' names are Luis, Juan, Daniel, etc. Right? And my sister's names are, again, in plural, sisters' names. Aquí dice los nombres de mis hermanas, en singular o en plural. In plural are María, Luisa, etc. Right? Yeah, okay, good. Lady. Lady. Viviana, what about you? Tell me about your family.
Hola.
Hello.
I have one brother and one sister. My brother's names are...
Name. My brother's name.
Names are Edgar. And my sisters, Maria, Isabel, Patricia.
Hey, pay attention. If you say in singular, you say is. My brother's name, like this, in singular, is. My brother's name is Luis. Si está en singular, utilizo is. Si está en plural, utilizo are. Okay, thank you.
I have
one
I have five brothers and one sister. My brothers' name are Junior, Aníbal, Francisco, Joel, Jeremías. And my sister is Leah.
And my sister is Leah. Okay. Leah, what about Leah? Tell me something about Leah. Leah?
Leah is very
intelligent.
It's very short.
Yeah, it's very short. And continue. Tell me more about Leah.
Have 10 years old.
Para decir la edad, no utilizo el verbo have, sino el verbo to be. Digo, she is 20 years old. She is 20 years old. Have, it is, for example, to express possession. Leah has a car. Leah has a very beautiful car. For example, Leah has a car. Leah has a book. Here, Leah has what else? Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. No more students? No? One more.
I have one sister. My sister's name is Diana. Diana has a cute cat.
Has a cute cat. Right. Excellent.
Thank you.
Very good. All right, so let's continue.
Hola. Uh-huh. I have one brother and one sister. My brother's name is Jorge. Sister is Maria. Maria has a dog.
Maria has a dog. Very good. Okay, so pay attention to singular and plural, please. Now, how old, when we talk about the age, pay attention, when we talk about the age, we never use have or has. In Spanish, we say, yo tengo 20 años, but in English, we use the verb be, and then we say, he is 5 years old. How old is your son? He is 5 years old. Or we only say he's five. But it is incorrect to say he's 5 years. We don't use only the word years. Or say years old or five, but no years. Right? How old is your brother? Viviana, how old is your brother? Viviana.
Sí, aquí estoy, teacher. ¿Me puede repetir, por favor?
How old is your brother? Do you understand the question? How old? We are talking about the age. They say, how old is your brother? Do you have a brother? Do you have a brother?
Yes.
No? Yes. Okay. How old is your brother?
He will be.
He's 20. Yeah. You can say he's 20 or he's 20 years old. It is okay. How old is your sister? Geoffrey, how old is your sister?
She is 43 years old.
He's 43 years old. How old is your wife, Guillermo?
What?
How old is your girlfriend or how old is your wife? How old is your mom?
Mom.
Ah, yeah, my mom.
She's 15 years.
15? No, 50. Maybe 50.
15.
¿Su mamá tiene 15 años? No. 15? No. No, it is 50. Yeah. My mom is 50.
Yes.
Okay. Dice aquí la regla que no puedo decir solamente years. 50 years es incorrecto. No puedo decir 50 years. O digo 50 years old o digo solamente 50, hasta el número. His or she's 50 or she's 50 years old, pero no puedo decir 50 years, okay? So, how old is your dad?
She's 50 years old.
Your dad, okay, she's 50 years old. Your mom, yeah. All right, very good. Uh-huh, here we have a picture. Do you know who are they? Who are they? Who are they? Do you know him? Do you know her? Do you know who are they?
Angelina. They are like married.
They are what?
They are married.
They are married. Okay, excellent. What else? They are, I think they are divorced. But anyway, yeah. Who are they? Try to describe them. Do you know their names?
There are actors and actors.
They are actors, right? They are actors. He is an actor or she is an actress. Okay. You can talk about them, about their names, about the age, about the occupation, and how do they look like, about brothers and sisters, etc. Well, you can say my no classmate because you don't have more classmates. We can say my brother. My brother is Marco. He is 25 years old. What about the occupation? What can you say about how do the he or she look like? No. Try to complete this. Talk about your brother.
My brother.
Talk about your sister.
Uh-huh. My brother is Robin. He is 40 years old. He is a doctor.
Mm-hmm. How does he look like? Look like it is the physical description. You can say he is tall, he is short, he is married. Is he married? No?
He's short.
Mm-hmm. He's short and intelligent. Okay. Right. One more. No?
My brother is Wilson. He's 29 years old. He's an engineer.
He's an engineer. How does he look like? What is his physical description?
He is very tall.
He's very tall. Is he intelligent?
Excuse me?
You can say he's very intelligent. He's so good looking.
Good looking.
He is good looking, right? Okay. Now let's remember about, this is a review about the time. Remember that in English we say, what time is it? What time is it? And the answer, we always use it's. And I say, hey, what time is the game? According to the picture, what time is the game? According to this, what time is the game?
It's a game 1 o'clock.
Yeah. Ponga atención. Para responder, si ya utilizo it's, ya no digo the game. Recuerde que it reemplaza a un sustantivo, o sea, está reemplazando a the game. Puedo decir it's at, the preposition at. It is at 1 o'clock. Sorry, I don't have the, no tengo el apóstrofe, pero aquí va un apóstrofe. So you can say the game. The game is at 1 o'clock, right? The game is at 1 o'clock. Yeah, what time is the dinner? What time is the dinner?
Half 2:40.
But pay attention. You have to say it's at or the dinner is at. Try to use the complete sentence. Repeat again. Dinner
is 1:45.
The dinner is at 1:40. Or you can say, pay attention, how many minutes do we need to reach number two? This is 20. You can say, it is at 20. Sorry. Hello. Hola, te llamo un ratito. Espérame un rato. I'm sorry. The dinner is at... sorry. The dinner is at... You can say 1:45, 1:40. Or the dinner is at 20 to 2. Do you remember this? No? Hello? Remember to say...
Puedes repetir, teacher.
Okay. I write here. Let me write. With this color. Right. Here I have. We can say the dinner... The dinner is at 1:40. This is okay. The dinner is at 1:40. Excellent. But you can also say in another form, how many minutes do we need to the 2? We have 5, 15, 20. It's at 20. 2, it is at 20 to 2. Do you understand? We have two forms to say the time. The exact time, it is at 1:40, or it is at 20 to 2. ¿Cuántos minutos me faltan para las dos? 20. Puedo decir, es 20 para las dos. Digo, 20 to 2. Right? But we use this after the half. Desde aquí, desde los 30 minutos, puedo decir 2. We can say 25 to 2, a quarter to 2, 10 to 2, 5 to 2. Do you understand? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, what about the concert? What time is the concert? What time is the concert?
The concert is 15 minutes.
Excellent. You say the concert is at 1:15. It is at 1:15. Good.
Minutes.
Yeah. Minutes. But pay attention. We can, this is one form. We have another form. Tenemos otra forma de decir la hora. Pasado. Las 12 de aquí. Puedo decir past. ¿Cuántos minutos se ha pasado de la una? 15.
Quarter.
15.
You can say it is 15 past 2. Past 1, sorry. The answer is 15 past 1, past 2. Right? What about the movie? What time is the movie?
The movie is at 6:30 minutes.
Okay, the movie is at 6:30. We can say it is at 6:30. Or it is at 6:30. Right, at 6:30. What time is it now? Right now, what time is it? Right now, what time is it? No? What time is it? Hello? Rosa, Ligia. Joanna, what time is it?
Saturday?
No, what time? Sorry, this is not. What time?
The time is 9:24.
We don't say the time is, we say it is, it's. What time is it? It's 9:24. Yeah, we say it is 9:24. Right, so. When we want to talk about the time, we have some questions, common questions. We say, what day is it? What day is it today? What day is today? You say, it's Saturday. Remember, we use it's. What day is it? It's Saturday. What month is it? It's December. What year is it? It's 2019. What's the day today? What's the day today? And we say it's December 14th or it's the 14th of December. Do you understand? Remember, it is used to refer about the time. What time is it? It's 9 o'clock. What day is it? It's Saturday. What month is it? It's December. What year is it? It's 2019. So, yeah. Here we have the prepositions. The prepositions of time. We use the preposition at. This preposition at, it is used with a specific time. A specific time, for example, we get up at 5 a.m. Don't forget to say at. I have lunch at 12. I go to school at 8 a.m. So at, it is used for specific time. La hora exacta. We use at. We exercise at 2 p.m. We use at with these expressions. Night, midnight, and noon. Say, so, I get home at night. No digo in the night. I get home at midnight. I get home at noon. Right? So, use the preposition at with expressions night, midnight, and noon. Now, the preposition in. Look at this, in. In is used with months. Say, my birthday is in October, in January, in February, in April. We use in with years, in 2019. We use in with expressions in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. Digo at night or in the evening. Pero no digo at and no digo in the night. No? In the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. And we use the preposition on, right? With the days of the week, with a specific day. on Tuesday, on Monday, on Thursday, on Saturday. And also with specific date. It means the date that contains a month, the day, and the year. In this case, we use on, right? The twins were born on March 3rd, 2019. And specific. From a time to time, you use the prepositions from and to. So we say, I have classes from 8 to 10, right? Now, what about this? My birthday is, what do you think? At, in, on, or from to?
In.
No.
On.
On. Remember, on con los días de la semana y con fechas completas. In con... What about the month? My birthday is...
My birthday is in October.
N. N is used with the months of the year, with years, and con las expresiones in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. What about the time, the specific time? I was born...
At.
I was born at. So, what about your birthday? Tell me about your birthday. I know, I'm sorry, this. I work
at
from 8:30 to 4:30. I teach a class at 8:30 on Monday and Saturday. Right. What about this? He swims
in.
In, with expressions in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. All right. So what about you? When is your birthday? When's your birthday? When's your birthday? When is your birthday?
My birthday is in September.
My birthday is in September. What day? Invent, imagine.
My birthday is on...
Invent.
On Monday.
On Monday. What time were you born?
I was born at 3 a.m.
3 a.m. Excellent. Okay. Good. Now let's see. Ordinal numbers. Do you remember the ordinal numbers? What is the first month of the year? What's the first month of the year? Hello?
January.
January is the first month of the year. And what is the second month of the year?
February.
February. What is the next question? ¿Cuál sería la siguiente pregunta?
What is the third month of the year?
What is the, we say third, repeat, third.
Third.
Excellent. What is the third month of the year?
March.
March. And what is the fourth month of the year?
April.
April. And what about the?
Fifth.
With TH. Fifth month of May. The year?
May.
May. And what is the?
June.
Sixth month of the year, June. And what about the next?
Seventh.
Seventh month of the year, July. And what about them?
Eight.
August.
Oh, August.
Oh, August. August. The eighth month of the year is August. Right. And the ninth month of the year, September.
September.
And what is that?
Ten.
Tenth month of the year, October.
October.
Pay attention to the ordinal numbers. The three first are different. First, second, and fourth, and third. Okay, they have a different ending. After number four, we add the TH to the number. Fourth, en el caso del five, la letra B con la E cambia por la letra F y digo fifth. A partir de fifth, van todos, añado TH. Sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, this is also different. We omit the letter E. Tenth, and we say, what is the next?
11.
What is the 11th month of the year? November. And look at this, the 12th. The 12th. This is the ordinal number for 12. Dice la regla, dice una regla que okay, look at this. And I say five. Cuando el sustantivo termina en V and E, para cambiar al ordinal, V and E changes by F, and then we add TH. The same happened with 12. It is the same number, 12. Here I have V and E. V and E, they take the form of F, and then we add TH, the 12th. Okay? And then we continue. After 12, we use 13, then we add TH. 14, TH. 15, it is the same, 15th. And then you continue, all right? These are the ordinal numbers. So, what's your birthday? Yeah, we say my birthday is in October on the 31st. Now, plural forms. How do we form the plurals? We normally add the letters S or ES to form plurals. But remember, the plural ending has three different pronunciations, like S, like this, like Z, or with an extra syllable, is. And here we have a suit, two suits, a book, two books, one skirt, three skirts, a chef, four chefs, with a clear S. La pronunciación es una letra S clarita, right? And don't forget, if you have here the plural, you need to add the letter S to the noun. No puedo decir two sisters. I have to say two sisters. Now, pay attention to this. A tie, two ties, two sweaters, three gloves, two blouses. When the word ends in a voiced sound, the pronunciation of letter S, it is with a kind of Z. Tie, ties. Sweater, sweaters. Gloves, blouses, with an extra syllable. This is an extra syllable, blouses. Yeah, sorry, this was a mistake. Two blouses, two dresses, sizes, taxes. To form the plural, we add es, es. But in the pronunciation, they are pronounced like an extra syllable is. Blouses, dresses, sizes, taxes. You see? This is only for pronunciation. Now, what are you wearing right now? Here we have some vocabulary. You see? T-shirt, tie, shirt, skirt, shoes, sweater, jacket, suit, dress, blouse, pants, jeans, etc. So, what are you wearing in this moment? For example, I am wearing a blue jacket, a white blouse, I am wearing a pair of jeans and shoes, high shoes. What about you? What are you wearing in this moment? Viviana, Joffrey, Lady, Guillermo, Joanna, Rosa, Ligia, Ariana. Could you describe what are you wearing?
I am wearing a black blouse, a blue pants, jeans, okay. A blue jeans.
We say a pair of jeans, a pair of jeans. This is the name, a pair of jeans.
Jeans and shoes, black.
The adjective goes before the noun. Say black shoes.
Black
shoes. Yeah, thank you. What about Guillermo? What are you wearing, Guillermo?
I am wearing blue jeans.
A pair of jeans. We say
a pair of jeans. Black blouse.
And no,
black.
You don't have blouse. No. Women, we wear blouses. Maybe you are wearing a t-shirt. Oh, sorry. T-shirt. Blouse means blusa. Los hombres no usan blusa.
I am wearing a shirt, black shirt.
A black shirt, yeah.
Black shirt, a pair of jeans, and
a pair of jeans,
and black tennis.
And black tennis shoes. All right, thank you. And what about Ligia? What are you wearing, Ligia?
I am wearing pink blouse, a red, a pair of jeans, red.
What is red? Red. You want to say red? The color red.
Yes, red.
A red pair of pants. Okay. So you are not wearing jeans. All right. So pay attention, please. Adjectives or colors are placed before nouns. We say a red blouse, a black blouse, a green blouse. Black jacket, green jacket, red jacket, etc. Adjectives, they go before the noun. Now, the use of this and that. This, it is used to express that an object, it is near the person who is speaking. For example, I say, this cell phone, because the cell phone is near me. Okay, so this is this cell phone. The object is near the person. It is only for singular. In Spanish, it means este, esta, esto. That, it is used also in singular to express that the object, it is far. The object, it is not near the person. The object, it is far away. See? The object is far, not near. In Spanish, this could be like ese, eso, esa, aquel, aquello, aquella. So, what do you think? The object is near the people. So, this or that?
This. Oh, car.
This. Pronunciation is with a short E. We don't say the, we say this.
This,
this is our car. And what about this? The object
that
is far.
That is car.
That is that. Car. Right. And what about this?
This is my dog.
My dog.
This.
Excellent. And this?
Tang.
That is his dog.
Right, very good. For plural, we use these words. These, ahora sí vamos a pronunciar clarito. These and those. This is the correct pronunciation. Remember, these, it is the plural of this. This in singular, this for plural. And also you have to check the plural are. These are my shoes. The object is near the person, but in plural. In singular, this. In plural, these. So, these are my things. These are my stuff. These are my students, for example. And those, it is to express something that is in plural, but far, very far. And we say, in singular, that, the plural, those. Those are your shoes. Those are your computers. Those are your books. Right? Do you understand? Yeah. Let's see this example. What about this?
These cats are young.
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 Which one? Pay attention. Esta palabra se pronuncia this, con una I bien corta, this. Y esta palabra se pronuncia these.
These cats are young.
Are young. Remember, these, it is for plural. Objects in plural that are near the person. These cats are young. And what about this?
That cat is old.
Old. And then?
This man is sad.
Esto significa, I'm sorry, esto es pronunciado this, and this is pronounced these. ¿Cuál es la pronunciación correcta?
This.
This.
This man is sad.
Mm-hmm. And?
Those people are happy.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. No, those, because it is far. Now, prepositions of place. Again, we have in, on, at. In, on, at are prepositions of time and also prepositions of place. When we want to express place, right, we use the preposition on with street names and with floors. We say, the office is on the second floor. The school is on the third floor. And also with street names. Pay attention to this. The name of the street goes before the word avenue. And I say, I live on Amazonas Avenue. The bank is on Amazonas Avenue, right? On with the names of streets. We use in with cities, states, countries, continents. And when we want to express that someone or something is inside a building. Example, in an apartment, in a house, in an office, in the hospital. When you want to express that it is inside a building. In Ecuador, in Pichincha, in Quito, in South America, inside a university. In. Now, preposition at. The preposition at, it is used to express a specific location, very specific, or a specific street address. What is specific? At home. At the new English school, it is not any school, it is the English school. I study at the new English school. I specify the place. Or at 50 Main Street, at 50 Amazonas Avenue, at 50 Juan Montalvo Street, for example. Remember the order. First of all, we write or we mention the number of the house, the name of the street, and at the end, we use the word street or avenue or road. At 5th Avenue and Broadway Street, when we have two streets. Yeah? Preposition at. So, where do you live?
I live in Colombia.
I live in Colombia. I live in Cali, Colombia. I live on Quincy Street and I live at 234 Quincy Street. Now, what about you? Where do you live? Where do you live?
I live on Ecuador.
¿Qué decía la preposición con ciudades, países, continentes? La preposición in. You can say, I live in Ecuador. I live in Quito. I live in Pichincha. I live in South America. Now, give me the complete address or give me the name of the street where you live. I live if you use the preposition on, we can only mention the name of the street. I live on Samaniego Avenue, for example. If you use at, you use the complete address. Where do you live? Viviana, Joffrey, lady.
Umbalación.
I live at what? Give me the complete address. First of all, you say the number. What's the number of your house? For example, I live at 345 Machal. I live at 345 Machala Street. This is my address. I live at 345 Machale Street. What about you? Where do you live? Hello?
I live at 7 Juan Bautista Street.
At 7 Juan Bautista Street. Only 7? Maybe 723, no? Okay. I live at 7 Juan Bautista Street. Thank you. What about Ligia? Ligia, where do you live?
I live on 100.
At.
100 is Enrique Arizaga Street.
Like this?
100? Enrique Arizaga Street.
Okay, Enrique Arizaga Street. All right. Right? So remember, first of all, we write the number, the name, and the word of street. At the end, we write the name of the street. Now, let's see a review of the present tense. The present tense. What is the present tense? Here we have some sentences. I watch, you watch TV, he watches TV, she watches TV, etc. Remember, when we are in the simple present tense, we add the letter S and sometimes the letters ES to the principal verb only for he, she, and it. Only for the person that replaces he, she, or it. For example, my father, my brother, my cousin, my mother, my sister. Okay, and here we can use any animal, etc. The third person of the verbs go, do, and have, they are irregular forms. And we say goes, he goes, she does, she has. Irregular forms. Let me see. And here we have, for example, the verbs need, like, want, have, right? We say, my sister has a new dress and she needs a new pair of shoes. For example, my mother has nice skirts, but she wants a new one. What about you? Use the words need, like, want, or have. What do you need? We are talking about clothes, for example, clothes. What do you need? What do you like? Or what do you want? Or what do you have? Give me some examples. What about you? Say, for example, I want. Talk about your clothes.
My sister has a new car and she needs new options.
A new options? What? New or new what? Could you repeat again? My sister has a new car and she needs a new
pair of shoes.
A new pair of shoes. Okay, you can say. What else? More examples. Give me examples using the simple present tense. Hello. No? What do you need? Joanna? I need.
I need a new shoes.
A new pair of shoes. Remember, shoes is plural. If you say a, you have to say a pair of shoes. En inglés decimos un par de zapatos. A pair of shoes. I need a new pair of shoes. Okay. What do you like? What do you want? Hello.
A new cell phone.
Yeah, but you need, you like, you want, or you have?
New.
You need a verb.
New.
I need.
Need.
So you say, I need a new cell phone. I need a new cell phone. Right. I need a new cell phone. Excellent. What else? I need what?
I need English class.
Okay. I need an English class. I need an English class. Good. I need an English class. And then we have here a sentence in the simple present tense. Remember, the present, okay, is used to express something that it is, like in this case, like it is a habit, a custom, a routine, something that you do every day. I need an English class, all right. In the simple present tense. She needs a new pair of shoes. Uh-huh. I want a new jacket. I have a blue jacket. Right? These are some examples of the present. Let me see. In the negative, for the negative form, remember, we need, for the negative sentence in the simple present tense, we need an auxiliary. The auxiliary, it is do and not. And we use do not with I, you, we, and they. And we say, I don't drink. I don't drink. We don't drink. You don't drink, and they don't drink. The auxiliary for I, you, we, and they is do. And for he, she, and it, for he, she, and it is does. And I say, she does not drink milk. He does not drink milk. It does not drink milk. Pay attention, as we are using an auxiliary does, the verb drink, it is in the simple form. We don't add the letter S or ES, okay? She does not drink milk. No letter S to the verb. Only in the affirmative sentence, I say she drinks milk in the affirmative. In negative, we don't use the letter S. Conjunctions of don't, doesn't, okay? So you say, I have a new cell phone, but I don't have a new computer. My brother has a, what do you say? But he doesn't need a, my brother has a cell phone, but he doesn't need a tablet, for example. An affirmative sentence and a negative sentence. So, give me only one example using the simple present in affirmative and in negative. Yeah, what can you say?
My sister has a car, but he doesn't need a house. He doesn't need a house.
But he doesn't need a house. Very good. Affirmative sentence and negative sentence. Okay, my dear students. Unfortunately, we don't have more time. Thank you. Thank you very much for coming to this class, face-to-face class. Thank you very much. Good luck and see you next time. Bye-bye.